Did you notice amidst all of that talk about winds, I skipped one of the most famous winds on Earth, the Santa Ana winds? Well, I leave those winds for now because they are tied both to the adiabatic processes and they're tied to orographic lifting and air descending on mountains. The Santa Ana winds are always dry. Often warm winds that blow into Southern California from the east and northeast. They are the result of a large high pressure system to the east and northeast of Southern California. Now, I say often warm because there are circumstances in which we can get a cold Santa Ana event. However, they are always dry. We are going to focus on the warm version. The four corner states are Arizona, New Mexico, Utah, and Colorado. Those states are to the east and northeast of Southern California. That is the area where the high pressure system needs to be established in order to create Santa Ana winds. Take a look at this map. You can see where they are. There you go. I circled the four corner states, so-called because they come together at right angles. You can see the maroon arrows, Arizona, New Mexico, Colorado, and Utah. Now I just put a big high pressure system right up over the top of those four corner states. Remember, in the northern hemisphere, the air circulates clockwise and outwards around a high pressure system. There we go. There's the circulation. Notice where Los Angeles is. Normally, in Southern California in particular, and California in general, we are under a westerly flow of air, which means the air comes from the west. As you can see, to the west of the state of California is the ocean. However, when high pressure is established over the four corner states, what ends up happening is it forces the air into Southern California from the east and northeast. In other words, we get an easterly or northeasterly flow of air. What is to the east and northeast of Southern California? Well, it's the Mojave Desert. Desert doesn't always mean hot, but desert means dry. This is going to be part of the origination point for the air that flows into Southern California during a Santa Ana event. And the air takes on the characteristics of whatever it's over. Since the air is starting out over the desert, it's going to start out dry. And you can see these yellow arrows point the direction of air movement from the Mojave into Southern California. Now, of course, this can blow into Northern California too, but I'm focusing on Southern California. A couple of years ago, the Los Angeles Times did a great report on the Santa Ana conditions. It was because we had a lot of fire. You can see that what's going on is we have a big high pressure system to the northeast of Southern California. The red arrows indicate the movement of strong northeast winds. And then you can see that offshore there's lower pressure. Remember, air flows from high to low. Then you can see this. The air is going to come from the desert. It's going to come up over the top of the mountains, and then it's going to descend towards the coastline towards Southern California. The big blue arrow indicates the movement of air from the desert over the mountains, and then the red arrows indicate the flow of that air downslope and into Southern California. Of course, as the air is coming down off the mountains, through the passes, and into Southern California, what's happening? Dry adiabatic rate. The air is warming up and it's drying out because of compression from increasing air pressure. Now, if you want to take this one step further, look at how big the blue arrow is in comparison to the red arrows. Because you have this very large volume of air that's coming from the desert. And if you notice where the red arrows start, the back end of the red arrows, it's in a kind of pass, like a bowed down area in the mountains. The air will move through the canyons and passes into Southern California. As it does that, the velocity increases as the air is going through those passes because you have this very large volume of air that's out in the desert. Now, that very large volume of air is going to have to squeeze through a much smaller volume of land. The only way for that air to squeeze through with that huge volume of air being pushed behind is to increase velocity. It's a little bit like this. If you take your hose, you turn your hose on full blast, so the water's passing through the hose at full velocity. And then you take your fingers and you begin to squeeze the hose so that you're shrinking the area that all of that volume of water has to go through. The only way for that volume of water to get through is for its velocity to increase. A similar thing happens as the air goes through the passes in California. And you can see with this diagram, at the top of the mountains, the air is relatively cool, but as it descends, it gets warmer and warmer. And of course, as it's warming up, it's drying out. These two pictures are satellite pictures of Southern California and Northern California during one of our Santa Ana events a couple of years ago when we had large fires. You can see the way the smoke is blowing offshore, that we are clearly under the influence of easterly or northeasterly winds. Which, of course, if you start a fire and the air is dry and the air is warm, it's going to exacerbate the problems. Whereas when you get an onshore flow and the air is wet, that tends to tamp down the fires.